فؤادك الأيام فت.
وقد قالت أم سليم رضي الله عنها: يا رسول الله خادمك أنس أدع الله له.
So the Sheikh رحمه الله, he's speaking about the issue of asking a person to make dua for you. It's permissible. So he's expanding and he's elaborating the evidences that have come regarding that a person is allowed to ask another person for dua to be made for them. And he brought the hadith narrated by Bukhari and Muslim in hadith Abi Hurairah. Umm Sulaym, who's the mother of who? Anas ibn Malik. He's his mother. She said to the messenger, Ya Rasulullah, O messenger of Allah, khadimuk anasun, your slave boy Anas, ud'u Allah lahu, make dua for him. Ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, supplicate for him. So there are many extensive du'as or evidences that a person can use to show that you're allowed to ask du'a from anybody. You're allowed to ask a righteous person to make du'a for you. You're allowed to. And the evidence for that is also the hadith Imam Muslim narrating the hadith Awais al-Qarani. It's a matter pertaining to Awais al-Qarani. The hadith like is narrated by Usayr ibn Jabirin. He said that Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, إذا أتى عليه أمداد أهل اليمن سألهم. That Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, if a delegation from the people of Yemen came to him, he would ask them, أفيكم أويس القرني, is he amongst you, أويس ibn عامر القرني, is he with you guys? That's what Umar ibn al-Khattab would say. حتى أتى على أويس, until Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, Awais al-Qarani came to him. فقال أنت أويس ibn عامر. Umar said to him, are you Awais ibn عامر al-Qarani, are you him? قال نعم, he said, yes I am. من مراد, he said, are you from the people of مراد? ثم من قرن, and then after that, are you from the people of قرن? قال نعم, he said, yes. قال, he said to him, فكان بك برص, you used to have leprosy. You see, فبرئت منه إلا موضع درهمة, and Allah gave you cure except a coin. Everything else went. He said, yes, it is me. He said, لك والدة, do you have a mother? قال نعم. He said, I heard the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم say, يأتي عليكم أويس بن عامر على أمداد أهل اليمن من مراد ثم من قرن. I heard the Messenger say that Uwais ibn Amir is going to come with a delegation from Yemen. He's from the people of Murad. From the people of Murad, he's from Qaran. كان به برص, he used to have leprosy. فبرئ منه, he became cured from it. إلا موضع درهم, except a coin-sized portion is not still with him. له والدة هو بها بار, he had a mother in which he was obedient to. He has a mother, he's very obedient to his mom. لو أقسم على الله لأبره, if he swears by Allah, Allah will be obedient to him. فإن استطعت أن يستغفر لك فافعل. If you guys are able to get from him to make forgiveness, ask forgiveness for you, the Prophet said, ask forgiveness. Go to him and say, ask forgiveness for us. عمر رضي الله عنه said, فاستغفر لي, ask forgiveness for me. فاستغفر لي, ask forgiveness for me. عمر رضي الله عنه then said to him, أين تريد, where do you want? أويس القرني said, الكوفة, I want كوفة, I want to go to كوفة. عمر رضي الله عنه said, ألا أكتب لك إلى عاملها؟ قال ألا أكتب لك إلى عاملها؟ Shall I, my governor there for me, shall I write for him to you? قال أكون في غبراء الناس أحب إلي. أويس القرني said, for me to be in the midst of the people and be unknown is more beloved to me. I don't want people to know me. I want people to leave me alone. قال فلما كان من العام المقبل حج رجل من أشرافهم. When the year next year came, a honorable man from his people came to visit عمر رضي الله عنه. You see, فوافق عمر, him and عمر met. فسأله عن أويس. عمر asked about the man. He said, tell me about أويس, how is he? He said, تركت رث البيت قليل المتاع. He said, I left him, a person who has very little in his house. He lives a very simple life, very. قال, he said, عمر رضي الله عنه said to the man, I heard the messenger say, يأتي عليكم أويس بن عامر مع أمداد أهل اليمن من مراد ثم من قرن كان به برص فبرئ منه إلا موضع درهم له والدة هو بها بار لو أقسم على الله لأبر فإن استطعت أن يستغفر لك فافعل. Umar said what he said to him, Awais al-Qarani, that he is a person who's going to come, a delegation of Yemen is going to come to you guys. He's from the people of, his name is Awais ibn Amir. He is from the people of Murad, thumma min Qaran. He has leprosy over his body. He's a size of a coin. He will be cured from it. He has a mother he's very obedient to. If he swears by Allah, Allah is very obedient. Allah does for him what he wants. If you are able to ask forgiveness from him, ask forgiveness. فَأَتَى أُوَيْسٍ and the people started to come to Uwais. فَقَالِ اسْتَغْفِرْ لِي قَالَ أَنْتَ أَحْدَثُ أَحْدًا لِسَفَرِ صَالِحٍ فَاسْتَغْفِرْ لِي قَالَ لَقِيتُ عُمَرْ قَالَ نَعَمْ فَاسْتَغْفَرَ لَهُ ها. فطفت له الناس فانطلق على وجهه قال أسير وكسوته بردة فلما كلما رآه إنسان قال من أين لأويس هذه البردة. أويس القرني رضي الله رحمه الله رحمة واسعة ورضي الله عنه. عمر رضي الله عنه, when he told that to the people, they went back and everybody started to ask forgiveness for him, and أويس رضي الله تعالى عنه, he tried to run away from the people crowding him and running after him. And that's how the righteous people always are. So this statement of Uwais radiallahu ta'ala anhu, or this hadith of Sahih Muslim, is evidence to show that you're allowed to ask forgiveness from a person. Now, but there's an issue, or there's a difference between istighatha and asking forgiveness from a person. Now,
وقد كان الصحابة رضي الله عنهم يطلبون الدعاء منه صلى الله عليه وسلم وهو حي.
And the Sahabas, the students, the companions, they used to ask the Prophet dua, supplication from him. And the Prophet was alive. They used to do that while he was alive, عليه الصلاة والسلام.
وهذا أمر متفق على جوازه.
And that is a matter which is unanimously agreed upon, its permissibility. It's allowed to do that.
والكلام في طلب القبوريين من الأموات أو من الأحياء الذين لا يملكون لأنفسهم نفعا ولا ضرا.
As for the statement, the speech regarding the grave worshippers who request from the dead or those who are alive that which they are unable, الذين لا يملكون لأنفسهم نفعا ولا ضرا, they are unable to bring good for their own selves and they are unable to bring harm to themselves. These people you're asking, they can't benefit themselves and they can't bring harm. Now, for you to use a comparison between something that is permissible shara'an, in the sharia is permissible, huh? Over something which is what? Different from it. Na'am.
وَلَا مَوْتًا وَلَا حَيَاتًا.
Who can't, unable to do naf' وَلَا ضَرْ. They can't bring good, they can't bring harm. They can't bring death, they can't bring life.
وَلَا نُشُورًا أَنْ يَشْفُوا مَرْضَاهُمْ.
And they are unable to what? They can't bring people back, resurrect them from their dead. They also are unable to cure those who are ill. نعم.
وَيَرَدُّ غَائِبِهُمْ وَيُنَفِّسُ عَنْ جُبْلَاهُمْ وَأَنْ يَسْقُوا زَرْعَهُمْ.
So what did they ask for them? They go to the grave and they ask him what? For them to bring back those, they lost properties. I've lost my camel, I don't know where it's gone. I lost my child, I don't know where he's gone. Bring him back for me. They also ask, you know, their women who are pregnant to ease in the pain for her. Things that they are unable to do. And they also ask what? Their gardens and their farms are watered for them. Na'am.
وَيَدَرُّ ضُرُوعَ مَوَاشِيهِمْ وَيَحْفَذُوهَا مِنَ الْعَيْنِ ونحو ذلك من المطالب التي لا يقدر عليها أحد إلا الله.
They ask for them to protect them from harmful things, evil eye, protect them from it. And matters ونحو ذلك من المطالب التي لا يقدر عليه إلا الله. And matters that no one is able to do except Allah تبارك وتعالى. نعم.
هؤلاء هم الذين قال الله تعالى فيه.
These are the people in which Allah has said in their regards. Allah said about them, hey?
وَالَّذِينَ تَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِهِ.
Those which you are calling on to besides Allah.
لَا يَسْتَطِيعُونَ نَصْرَكُمْ.
They are unable to give you guys victory.
وَلَا أَنفُسَهُمْ يَنْصُرُونَ.
And they can't give victory to their own selves.
إن الذين تدعون من دون الله عباد أمثالكم.
Those in which you call on to besides Allah are like, or they are slaves like you guys. Those in which you call on to besides Allah are slaves like you guys.
فكيف يطلب الإنسان من الجماد أو
How can a person request from a object? A jamad is something that's a wall, a stone, a rock. How can you ask from them? How can you request from them?
أو من حي الجماد خير منه لأنه لا تكليف عليه.
Or from a living jamad is better for him than that which because it has burden on it. Takleef has been placed on it.
وهذا يبين ما فعله المشركون في
And this clarifies what the pagans and the polytheists used to do.
في عبادة الأصنام.
In their worshipping of idols.
وهذه هي بعينها العبادة.
And this itself is عبادة.
وهذه النذور بالأموال وجعل قسط للقبر. كما يجعلون شيئا من الزرع يسمونه تلما في بعض الجهات اليمنية وكذلك يجعلون لهم نصيبا من أنعامهم وهو بعينه الذي كان يفعله المشركون الذين حكى الله ذلك عنهم في قوله تعالى وجعلوا لله مما ذرأ من الحرث والأنعام نصيبا فقالوا هذا لله بزعمهم وهذا لشركائنا.
Can I have your copy? All of that wasn't in there for me. نعم. وهذه النذور and all of these oaths in which they make for the dead. وَجَعْلُ قِسْطٍ لِلْقَبْرِ And to make a portion for the graves. To make it for the graves. قِسْط is a portion. كَمَا يَجْعَلُونَ شَيْئًا مِنَ الزَّرْعِ Like the same way they make a portion of the farm when they take the crops. They make it for what? They make it for the آلِهَة. يُسَمُّونَهُ They call it تِلْمَن We spoke about that before. فِي بَعْضِ الْجِهَاتِ الْيَمَنِيَّةِ In some of the lands in Yemen. وَكَذَلِكَ يَجْعَلُونَ And they also make لَهُمْ نَصِيبًا مِنْ أَنْعَامِهِمْ They also make a portion of their cattle for them. They said, my cattle, this one, they go and they slaughter the cattle and they say, it's for you, or the person in the grave. وَهُوَ بِعَيْنِهِ And this exactly is الَّذِي كَانَ يَفْعَلُهُ الْمُشْرِكُونَ That which the pagans and the polytheists used to do. الَّذِي حَكَى اللَّهُ ذَلِكَ عَنْهُمْ In which Allah told us about them. في قوله in his statement, in his speech, وَجَعَلُوا لِلَّهِ They made for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala مِمَّا ذَرَأَ مِنَ الْحَرْثِ وَالْأَنْعَامِ نَصِيبًا فَقَالُوا هَذَا لِلَّهِ بِزَعْمِهِمْ وَهَذَا لِشُرَكَائِنَا فَمَا كَانَ لِشُرَكَائِهِمْ فَلَا يَصِلُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَمَا كَانَ لِلَّهِ فَلَا يَصِلُ إِلَى شُرَكَائِهِمْ سَاءَ مَا يَعْمَلُونَ سَاءَ مَا يَحْكُمُونَ Sorry. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said, وَجَعَلُوا They made from their farms and also from their cattle a portion And you know what they said? فَقَالُوا هَذَا لِلَّهِ بِزَعْمِهِمْ This is for Allah. وَهَذَا لِشُرَكَائِنَا And this is for our what? For our idols and those what we worship. This is for Allah, this is for the idols. Ah. So what that's exactly what these people are doing are exactly بِنَصِّ الْآيَةِ It shows بِعَيْنِ فِعْلِ الْمُشْرِكِينَ That is exactly what the pagans and the polytheists were doing. نعم.
وَقَالَ وَيَجْعَلُونَ لِمَا لَا يَعْلَمُونَ نَصِيبًا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ
Allah said, وَيَجْعَلُونَ they make. لِمَا لَا يَعْلَمُونَ that which they don't know, نَصِيبًا a portion. مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ that which we gave them. The word مِن, your ma, it comes from. أي مِن بَعْضِ مَا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ Some of that which we gave them. Some of that which we gave them, they started to make it for the idols. You see? نعم.
تَاللَّهِ لَتُسْأَلُنَّ عَمَّا كُنْتُمْ تَفْتَرُونَ
Grave worshippers, تَاللَّهِ Allah is swearing by himself. لَتُسْأَلُنَّ You will be questioned. عَمَّا كُنْتُمْ تَفْتَرُونَ The false accusations you used to make, iftira, you will be held account for the day of judgment. About lying about Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. نعم. So the person has to be scared and worried, wallahi. That this matter is questioned. نعم.
فهؤلاء القبوريون والمعتقدون في جهال الأحياء وضلالهم سلكوا مسالك المشركين حذو القذة بالقذة.
لا, these grave worshippers, these grave worshippers, فهؤلاء القبوريون, these grave worshippers, والمعتقدون في الجهال الأحياء, and who also believe in the affairs of these ignorant ones who are alive, who they look at them as awliya from Allah, they look at them like that, but they're juhal, ignorant ones themselves, and those who they are ascribing the allies of Allah are juhal. وَضُلَّلِهِمْ, and they're misguided one. What did they do? سَلَكُوا, they took مَسَالِكَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ, they took the path of the mushrikeen, and look at this, حَذْوَ الْقُذَّةِ بِالْقُذَّةِ, they took it bit by bit. The word قُذَّة is رِشُّ السَّهْم, meaning they took نَهَجُوا نَهْجَهُمْ, they took their steps. And that is exactly what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said about the Muslimin. What did he say about them? لَتَتَّبِعُنَّ سَنَنَ مَنْ كَانَ قَبْلَكُمْ, you guys are going to follow the path of those who came before you. So what did he say? حَذْوَ الْقُذَّةِ بِالْقُذَّةِ, some of the narration say, you will follow them. أَمَا حَذْوَ النَّعْلِ بِالنَّعْلِ, some of the narration said, شِبْرًا بِشِبْ وَذِرَاعًا بِذِرَاعَ, a hand span. Long, you follow the kuffar. Whatever they do, you find the Muslims do it. The Prophet, look what he said, حَتَّى لَوْ دَخَلُوا جُحْرَ ضَبِّ اللَّ دَخَلْتُمُ, even if they go into the hole of a lizard, you'll find the Muslims try to go into a lizard hole with them. How much they follow them. Then the Sahabas, they said, Al-Yahud wa Nasara, are you speaking about the Jews and the Christians? The Prophet looked at the Sahabas and said, Faman, who else are they going to follow? Na'am. So you find that the grave worshippers, they have what? They have followed the path of the mushrikeen, the pagans and the polytheists, in which the Prophet fought against, alayhi salatu wa salam.
فاعتقدوا فيهم ما لا يجوز أن يعتقد إلا في الله.
They started to believe about their graves and also about their so-called awliya, that which is not permissible to be believed in anyone except Allah. Those are only things that we should believe in for Allah. They started to believe that these things can be done by who? By their awliya. Mm-hmm.
وَجَعَلُوا لَهُمْ جُزْءًا مِنَ الْمَالِ,
and they made some of their wealth for them.
وَقَصَدُوا قُبُورَهُمْ مِنْ دِيَارِهِمْ لِزِيَارَةٍ,
and they intended the grave of their what? Of them. They travel from their country just so they can go to the grave of what? Wali, Fulan, or this person, so they can go to his grave, which is far, so they can visit it. Now, the Sheikh here right now, what we have to realize is مجرد شد الرحال, the mere fact of شد الرحال, to travel for a grave is not shirk. Just to travel for a grave is not shirk. لكنه معصية, or it's a وسيلة, it's a means. الحمد لله يهديكم الله ويصلح بالكم. مجرد شد الرحال, the mere fact of what? Traveling for the graveyard is not shirk in and within itself. Lakin it's what? It's a means to shirk. It's a what? It's a means to shirk. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he prohibited for a person to travel to a graveyard. Pay attention, not visit. There's a difference between visiting and traveling. You're allowed to go and visit the graveyard once you're there and say, you know what, akhi, I want to go to the graveyard to visit it. Why? Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, كُنْتُ نَهَيْتُكُمْ عَنْ زِيَارَةِ الْقُبُورِ فَزُورُوهَا فَإِنَّهَا تُذَكِّرُكُمْ بِالْآخِرَةِ, I used to prohibit you from visiting the graves, I now verily advise you or urge you to go and visit the grave. That is permissible. لكن to travel from a very far place and country from country, so you can only go to a graveyard, this is another ruling, and it falls under the hadith of the Prophet's prohibition, لَا تَشُدُّ الرِّحَالِ إِلَّا إِلَى ثَلَاثَ مَسَاجِدٍ, that you're not allowed to cut a flight or a distance like that for nothing except what? Three masjids. I mean, taqarruban, of course, trying to get closer to Allah, you can only do it for these three. Masjidi hadha, my masjid. You see, Masjid al-Haram, and also Bayt al-Maqdis. Those three, you can travel for them. You want to go and see them. That's why you're going. You see?
وَطَافُوا حَوْلَ قُبُورِهِمْ وَقَامُوا خَاضِعِينَ عِنْدَ قُبُورِهِمْ,
they done tawaf around the qubur? Some people believe what? Going to this grave is equal to what? It's equal to how many umrah? This much umrah. You see? ولذلك it said, for example, some of these awliya that the people say they're awliya or that sects praise, some of them have never even been to Hajj. They've never been Hajj. What do they do? They stay in what? In the graves of there, and they do tawaf there. They don't even go Hajj. Na'am. And then وَقَامُوا خَاطِعِينَ عِنْدَ قُبُورِهِمْ. And they go to the grave and they humiliate themselves.
وهتفوا بهم عند الشدائد.
And they call on to them, times of hardship, and they run to them. نعم. لذلك والله, one time I remember, I was in Somalia, and in the masjid, والله خطبة الجمعة finished. You see, and when the خطبة الجمعة finished, I don't even know if I can call that a خطبة, that what I listened to. But anyways, after the خطبة was over, when we prayed the salah, a man stood up. And he spoke to the people. He said, people, do you know why rain isn't coming down? Do you know why the land is barren? We're not receiving rain? We're wondering. At this point, you're going to think to yourself that this man is going to say that we've disobeyed Allah. وَكَذَلِكَ أَخْذُ رَبِّكَ إِذَا أَخَذَ الْقُرَى وَهِيَ ظَالِمَةٌ إِنَّ أَخْذَهُ أَلِيمٌ شَدِيدٌ. The people disobeyed Allah. Tawheed has not been established. Fear of Allah, if we come back with it, if we come with the taqwa that is needed, you think that's what he's going to say? Ya ahl al-kitabi lastum ala shay'in hatta tuqim at-tawrat. You owe the people of the books. You're nothing unless you establish the tawrat. You know? Or the ayah, la akalu min fawqim aw min tahti arjulihim. If you feared Allah and you came with his awamir and his orders, you would have eaten from the rain would come down. You would eat from the earth. I mean, Allah will bring you back everything you guys want. No, he didn't say that. He said, the reason why we're not getting rain, the reason why poverty has stricken us and we're suffering is because the awliya have been forgotten. We need to go to the graveyards and remember the awliya. He said that you rarely see anyone sitting in the graveyard anymore and asking the awliya for help and support. You see, that's why Allah Ta'ala brings the adab. That's why the adab doesn't stop. That's why it doesn't stop. So then, he's ordering us to come with shirk, to call onto the graves. Clearly, go and beg the graves and the people in the graves. That's where the problem is from. Naam. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un.
وَنَحَرُوا تَقَرُّبًا إِلَيْهِمْ وَهَذِهِ هِيَ أَنْوَاعُ الْعِبَادَاتِ الَّتِي عَرَّفْنَاكَ.
And they slaughter, trying to get closer to them. And these are the types of ibadat in which we have explained it to you before. We've spoken about it.